ask to siphon them, they started to ask to battle them. I don't have to tell them, I don't have to come on them, I don't have to push them into the circle. They're asking to do that, and that's progression. That's progression. Progression here, then progression here.
I want them to learn the basic foundation. I want them to have it down to the T, because that's where it all matters at the end of the day, the basic elements of the dance. Mainly from just people, what they see, like spinning on their head and stuff like that, that comes later. So from now, for this week, I want them to really get the foundation down, to understand the dancing of it. And the main things are top locking, footwork, and a little bit of freezes here and there, so they can put stuff together and play with it like puzzles, you know. So I really want to get a lot of steps in there, into their mind, to their muscle memory, so they can go home, practice it, make routines with their friends and things. They're brilliant. I think that, you know, every day they're working harder. As much as I punish them, they actually love it, and, you know, we're actually building a little family. I'm going to miss it, really, because I'm getting really attached to them.
Basically trying to help them either create variations of what they've learned with AJ already, and how to connect it with the new stuff I'm teaching them, and how to just take it to the next level. And everyone seems to be connecting the dots slowly, some faster than others in some ways and maybe not in other ways. Like, I might teach something and my next step is to connect it with the stuff I just taught 5 minutes ago, and some people in the class already do.
Heard from the teachers, now let's hear from the driving force behind the school itself.
I started dancing when I was 4 years old. It was while I was studying my degree that I got a scholarship to go to America and train with the Lamone Dance Company, and it was there that I think I saw firsthand breakdancing for the first time. Breakin Edge started basically because I saw all the good qualities that it brought out in the students who were training up. They'd become focused, motivated, and I wanted to share that with other students. I want to give them something to be passionate about, something to enjoy, something that they love. What next? True School 2012. What are we in?
2010.
At the minute we're training hard for True School 2011, and hopefully for Breakin Edge to continue. I think that it's been successful and we would like to continue our work in the community.
Let's see what more of the students got up to during the week and hear what some of them have to say.
Set your mind on something, you can get better and better, and eventually you'll be able to do it.
I did Breakin Edge because I want to progress more as a breakdancer and take it further, maybe possibly to a career.
That a whole week long of learning with professionals is going to help us in further routines at the True School.
Because we get to learn new stuff from professionals, and they're actually amazing dancers.
I did Breakin Edge because I like breakdancing.
It's given me more confidence.
And it's given me a lot more confidence.
More confidence than how fun dance can be. It's time to learn.
a dip, dive, dip. You might break your hip to the sound of legit.
What's been fun is learning new moves. We've been learning new skills.
Learning new tricks.
New moves, how to link moves, more moves.
Learning new moves.
How to do different types of moves.
Learning loads of new moves.
Making sure my sound hits from here to Grenada. Honey gave me skins, man, I told her friends I ate her. Oh wait, I'll save the subject for later. But it's time to get wrecked with the creator.
Probably learning the new moves.
The most difficult part of breaking the edge would probably be getting up early. Doing lots of drills. I think the footwork, because my legs really ache.
What's been difficult?
That's what I give them. Honey's for my line, cause I always seem pretty good. Really enjoyed it.
The best thing has been having mentors here to teach us new things.
It's been hard work, but it's paid off. We're all good at Top Rocks. Sweating out.
There is potential in the class, but the ones that should be inspiring me are the ones that I wouldn't think the potential is coming from. So there is a big range of potential out there. There is a huge market out here now. So everyone has the idea of potential and everyone has the opportunity to be great. It's just whether they take it and run with it.
At the end of each session, the students would take place in a cypher. Let's see how they did.
I started off in an after-school club. and now I'm representing the UK at the World Finals, so it's a good place to start school.